Being here at the United Nations in New York City and meeting with indigenous peoples from around the world, it's so powerful. They do it because they know that there is a line that we have to draw and say, this isn't just a game, this isn't just a meeting in a building. There's a reality to us wanting to protect our future. And so I think it's important to lift up the struggle of indigenous women, not wanting to just be in the household or cooking or seen with these traditional roles. If people here know the struggles that exist in other areas and territories, there could be that compassion to somehow help, especially with the women and children in their struggle for land right and land title.
But I want to place these in, quote, positive changes in terms of how the bank has responded to FPIC and this emerging international law within a broader critique of what's known as the development apparatus.
We are right now here at the A Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues is the 17th session and is talking about lands and territories. Indigenous people are marginalized in almost all development. That's why we are effectively participating in the agendas 2030 and about the Sustainable Development Goals. And we are really pushing that no one is left behind, no matter how remote you are.
I'm so happy to be at this 17th session of the Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues. The theme of this year, which is Indigenous Collective Rights to Land, Territories and Resources, is a very important issue for us as Indigenous people and pastoralists as well. I will plead that women land rights and girls in particular and Indigenous human rights defenders regarding land issues should be also taken into consideration.
Estoy participando en este foro de pueblos indígenas con el propósito de plantear la situación de las mujeres, de los jóvenes y los pueblos indígenas. Pero fundamentalmente lo que venimos a demandar a los estados y a las Naciones Unidas y a las instituciones financieras es el máximo respeto a los derechos humanos de los pueblos indígenas porque somos sujetos de derecho individual y colectivo. Venimos a demandar de que se nos respete el consentimiento libre, previo, informado, antes de echar cualquier proyecto en nuestros territorios.
We are here to recommend the UN to have a special mechanism for free, prior, informed consent, which is enshrined in United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Lot of land grabbing and militarization and violence against women is happening in my country.
So these are some of the challenges that people face.
Yo vengo hablando sobre este derecho de los pueblos indígenas, también contaminación del agua, que es están lavando oro, entonces contaminan el agua. Entonces ahí las mujeres necesitamos el agua, jalamos muy largo, a veces 2 horas. 3 horas van a traer agua, entonces hablamos derecho de las mujeres también.
We're asking to UN agencies that please let us live in our own land. In the hilly side, there are lots of hydropower projects which were indigenous people living in the hillsides are displacing by the hydropower projects, which is unfair. We want to ask UN agency to support us to pressurize our government to stop this kind of violence, which is we are facing nowadays.
So thank you, our time is up and we have to move on to the next side event. Thank you everybody, want to get us.
Indigenous women from these poor countries, as we call ourselves, they're always resilient. No matter what burden it is, we carry with a positive thinking that something will be okay. And the little things that we do really matter because those are the things that we do and we build up and make a difference for our community.